and welcome back to our last and final episode for the semester of the Round Table Talk. Oh my gosh. I'm one of your hosts, Tony Hall.
Anthony Peterson.
And I'm LaMaya Polina.
And guys, this is the Round Table Talk. Today is actually a very, very special show today. Mm-hmm. We have all of our hosts from all of the PVTV shows here today. So we'll meet up with them a little after the break. Let's get the show started, y'all. How was your Thanksgiving?
It was good. I waited a long time to eat. That's not what that is.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. It's like Thanksgiving. You see everybody eating, and all you gotta do is watch a football game. My team didn't even play.
Who's your team?
The Packers. Oh, the Packers.
All right.
But yeah, I guess it was all right other than that.
I didn't go anywhere for Thanksgiving. Well, I went to my line sister's house for Thanksgiving, but then after that, I just went to my little house in Walla County and went to sleep because I'm so tired. I'm ready for the semester to be over. But did y'all see the Lion King trailer?
Bro, I haven't seen the trailer, but I got to see the lineup of who's playing who.
Beyonce's in it.
Yes.
Uh-huh. I seen a little the part where they rubbed the red thing and put it up.
Yeah, I saw that too.
I seen the cartoon part, but I seen the real part too. And I was like, ooh, wee.
Y'all. Well, my Thanksgiving was pretty good. I went to New Orleans for Thanksgiving.
What you do in New Orleans?
Yeah, what you do in New Orleans?
I was feeling myself this break a little bit. Posted a couple pictures. But I went to go hang out with my best friends and her family for Thanksgiving. It was great. I ate nothing but seafood the whole time I was there. Yeah, I know. And I didn't have to pay for nothing.
I eat anything if I don't got to pay
exactly.
for it.
Exactly.
What are those drinks called that come in the... I've never been to Orleans.
What are those called?
Hurricanes.
Grenades. Grenades. Yeah.
Did you have one of those?
I did.
I've never been to New Orleans.
Oh, you just live in New Orleans.
New Orleans is great. Yeah, yeah. It's man, the culture out there, y'all. Like, that city deserves like a full blown out documentary. Mm-hmm. Like, the culture out there is second to none. Like, it's amazing. It's amazing.
Speaking of childhood movies and videos, old SpongeBob gone.
Man.
What you mean SpongeBob is gone?
Steven Hillenburg passed away.
Yeah.
That's the creator of SpongeBob. And I guess it affects everybody, but I didn't have cable. I had Arthur Living. But he did something special for everybody. It's very much appreciated. I watched SpongeBob before I go to sleep all the time.
I've been watching SpongeBob
for 20 years.
Yeah. Forever.
How old are you?
I'm 22.
You ain't even know what SpongeBob was.
Yes, I was.
For 20 years.
I remember SpongeBob ever since I can remember. SpongeBob's been in my life forever.
Yeah, I remember the very first episode. Like,
SpongeBob's been on for 20 years.
I think he first met Sandy or something.
Yeah. So do y'all think if he died, the creator, is SpongeBob gonna be done? Are they gonna continue?
SpongeBob
or no?
Forever.
Oh no!
That's SpongeBob, baby.
that's legendary. SpongeBob.
But it is crazy. We lost Stanley and Steven Hillenburg all in really a matter of a couple weeks. Hmm. Our childhood is we grown now.
What's his name? Say it again. SpongeBob's creator.
Oh, Steven Hillenburg.
He was only like what in his 50s?
He's 57. He died at 57.
How he die?
I think it was ALS. Remember back in the day we did the ice bucket challenge?
When y'all did the ice bucket challenge?
And I know I was one of those ones that did the ice bucket challenge. Yeah. I was trying to, you know, stay trendy with the world. But I didn't know what ALS, I didn't know what that was at the time. Mm. But now.
What is it?
I still don't really remember.
What else is happening? What else is going on?
The end of the semester.
Yeah, that's really it.
Yeah.
Well, it's set time of asking teachers, what can I do?
Extra credit.
I'm finna graduate.
Extra credit.
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Bro, let me tell y'all the story of what happened to me, actually. So I had missed a day of school, and that was like it for my attendance. Mm-hmm. That was it. So I had to go to my professor's office and basically like try to explain myself. you know, when you really trying to, like, beg somebody, yeah. like, you start looking around their room to see, like, what's, like, relatable to your right. life and uh-huh. stuff.
Girl, I did that today with my food stamps.
Yeah.
I got awarded. Never mind, keep going. We'll talk about that another day.
No, that's exactly, like, what I did. I had to just try to make connections. So I guess I can say a tip for the end of the semester. If you're in, like, the boat of all fail, if you gotta go talk to your professor, make sure, and you don't know what to say, make sure you look around their office to see if you can relate to anything and then start talking about that. Because my professor went to UT and I used to live in Austin. And I was like, oh my gosh, that was actually my first collegiate football game I ever went to. And they're like, oh my God. And I
was
like,
was this this semester?
It was this
Do you
semester.
Think your teacher watching the show right, gonna be watching the show?
You know what? That's a good question.
They won't see it. They won't see it
until
after the semester.
Yeah, you see it after
That's
the
what
semester.
You think.
Then we'll talk. We'll laugh about it later.
Oh, Lord.
You got any end-of-semester tips?
I need some tips myself. I'm
stressed. Finals. Oh, my gosh. Is it finals next week?
Yeah.
It is.
I got a final on Monday. We're taking it early, but I don't have any tips. Drink lots of plenty of water. Make sure that you're studying days before your test, not the night before. Do not try to cram everything.
And if you don't know it, then you don't know it.
I thought you were going to say, if you don't know, now you know.
Yeah, I did too.
I don't know. If you don't know that work, you're not going to know it. And just take the class again.
Yeah, I feel you. I'm kind of in that boat right now.
Don't say that.
I mean, let's encourage the students.
If at first you don't succeed, try again.
Get yourself up and try it again.
Exactly. The stuff off. And try again.
We're going to break, y'all. We'll be right back with the round table.
Nope, we not going to break right now. We're not going
just
to break.
Just kidding.
Right now.
Yes, we are going to break. No break. We'll be
today.
Right back.
We don't got no breaks.
No?
Dude. No, we don't have no breaks right now.
Wow. Mm-mm. Our producers are confused.
Traditions are not made overnight. They are created through a legacy of excellence and a commitment to something much greater. For more than 135 years, Prairie View A&M University has provided students with a strong academic foundation, a unique college experience, and the opportunity to make their mark on the world. This is a place where friendships are formed, discoveries are made, and dreams are realized. This is Prairie View A&M University, our tradition, your opportunity.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University, our tradition, your opportunity.
Prairie View A&M University, we've been igniting passion in students for more than 140 years. It's about inspiration. It's about global influence. It's about self-expression and individuality. It's about trailblazing a path of excellence. It's about engaging in the greater community. Above all, it's about helping you realize your dreams. Ignite your passion. Experience Prairie View A&M University.
And we're back on the round table talk, and actually we're here with all of PVA and UTV, all the hosts, and this is pretty different, but we can get right into it.
We got
Zone 4, we got the Panther News Network, the Panther Sports Zone, and they're out here at the round table.
It's about time,
brother.
Well, damn.
I'm sorry.
Man, look, I'm so sorry for all, like, the jitters. We're just so excited to be here with y'all today. Like, this is greatness right here on stage.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Well, welcome. Congratulations to your first semester doing your own shows and being the first Prairie View host and talent on air and we're also working on our website, so y'all stay in tune with that for that. And you heard it here.
Let's get it popping. Yeah. I guess, y'all, how is it actually being on set, being in y'all's positions on these different shows?
Chaz, start it off, Chaz. Yeah. You look nice today.
Well, thank you.
You got a mic behind you.
I would say that this experience has been, it's been really fun. I like it to learn new things and embark on, you know, new journeys in different areas of my life. So doing these shows and having the opportunity to do something that I'm interested in has been completely fun. It is a lot of hard work behind the scenes, like, you know, developing the show and your content. It is hard. It's time consuming, but it's fun overall.
How has it made you grow?
One way for sure, well, two ways, are my time management and my organization. Mm-hmm. Because doing this and having, you know, a full load of classes, you have to put your time in the right places and utilize it productively. Mm-hmm. So that's two ways that it's made me grow or helped me to grow.
I got a question for the sports show. How do y'all personally feel about the sports show? Because I feel like I like the round table talk. It's cool. I'm learning a little.
We're laid back.
Yeah, we laid back. But sports is something that everybody talks about, like, no matter where. How do y'all feel about y'all's show?
I like it. It's not too hard. We're pretty much laid back. It's like a discussion type show. It's kind of hard on preparation because sometimes games might go until like midnight or 1 or 2. Like that Dodgers and Astros. Yeah, some NLS game or the game didn't end until like 2 in the morning. So we had to stay up.
You gotta look at it.
Yeah, we gotta watch that stuff, make sure everything's accurate and stuff. And we may get like some updates like right before the show goes on or like during the show. So it definitely keeps us on our toes and just like helps us grow and be better every show. What you think?
Can y'all say your names as
well? I was gonna say, pause before you get started. Can you guys say your name and the show that you guys represent? We're just gonna go down the line.
All right, I'm David Smith, Missouri City, Texas, junior mass communication major. I'm an anchor for the Panther Sports Zone.
Yeah.
All right, I'm Zach Collins. I'm from Arlington, Texas. I'm a mass communications major, senior, and Panther Sports Zone is our show.
Wait, so am I answering the question?
We're gonna go down the line.
So I'm just introducing myself?
Just introduce
How you
yourself.
Doing? Zone 4 over here, one of your co-hosts, Jamarcus Jones. You probably know me as Jay Jones. Working at Zone 4 is a great experience, you know?
Hi, my name is Dre Marquis. You already know who it is, what it is, what I'm about to do. But I represent Zone 4, and I am a junior from Dallas, Texas, mass communication.
Yes.
Hello, everyone. My name is Tanae Davis. I'm also a host of The Zone 4 from Dallas, Texas. I am a senior mass comm major, digital media arts minor.
My name is not Ashley, it's Ashlyn. Hey, Miss Tosin, if you know me, and I am a co-host for Zone 4, and I'm from Lake Jackson, Texas. I'm a mass communications major and a psychology minor.
It's about time.
I got a mic. Okay. Good people, y'all know who I be. I'm DeAndre Nicholson. I'm from Mesquite, Texas. The mass comm major, I graduated in December.
Congrats.
Appreciate the good people.
And you are the host for...
It's About Time.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I'm Jeray Beach. I'm an anchor for Panther News Network and also Panther Sports Zone recently, so it's been kind of fun. Mass communications major, graduating senior in December.
Look at you.
Congrats.
Hello, my name is Chaz Nolan. I'm from Beaumont, Texas. I am a senior and a mass comm major here at Prairie View, obviously, and I am an anchor for the Panther News Network here.
Okay.
Wow.
DeAndre, Matt X, last year I haven't really been a part of the mass communications program for a long time. I really just got into it last year. Really just started doing classes for it last year, as a matter of fact. And you were starting to do a show, It's About Time, before all of this started. So how do you feel to, I guess you can kind of consider yourself to be a somewhat of a foundation for all of PVAMU-TV. How do you feel about being that first building block for PVAMU-TV?
It's surreal, but I don't want to take all the credit for it, because all of this is happening because of TDV,
sure.
Professor Dalvez.
For sure.
So if she didn't give me that opportunity, it wouldn't have been one for me to, you know, have success, and then for y'all to come on and take that success to another level.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it was fun doing it, you know, just then. But now to be a part of a team, to see everybody go from where we were, you know, finding out that we got the shows in the summer to where we are now, and this being like the last, this being the last week for everybody's shows, it's surreal. It was fun, you know. I'm sad to go, but you know, people here that's gonna come up and take the banner and run with it and take it further than we did. So it's, I mean, it's fun.
For the entertainment for Zone 4, what is your greatest achievement this semester as a whole?
I think our greatest achievement was pulling through. You know, we had a lot of, you know, just like all shows, you know, you have a few hiccups, but we all seem to, you know, pull through. Like, sometimes we'll come in and we're like, oh, man, you know, we're just frazzled. We're like, okay, we got to talk about this, we got to talk about that. Like the sports news, like, we're always, you know, entertainment is always updated. So, you know, we have news from the previous week and news coming up in, like, the next 30 seconds. So it's like, it always keeps us on our toes. So I think, you know, we just pull through. We finesse. What you think?
I believe that our biggest achievement this semester was working together as a team.
Yeah.
We have a lot of different personalities on the show.
Yeah.
And normally at college, a lot of different personalities don't match. They can't work together.
Mm-hmm.
But I believe that was the diversity. That's what made our show diverse in a sense, because we're all different, including the swing coach. We're all different. And so when we come together and we put that energy together, it's just like, oh, wow, this is something that needs to go further than, you know, just Prairie View. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like our biggest achievement was working together as a team with different personalities.
That's what's up.
What do you guys think you could have done better in any of your shows?
And that's really open up to everyone. Anyone can answer that question. If y'all want to do it, whoever wants to answer the questions, can actually just take it up.
All right. So one thing about the Sports Zone is, like, it could be just repetitive multiple times, and, like, it'll get boring. So we got to – no, just being honest. Like, it'll get boring sometimes, so you got to come up with, like, new segments and, like, just different ideas on how to, like, present, you know, different sports stories and just, like, making everything, keeping it fresh, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
I feel like one thing that we could improve on at Zone 4 was structure.
Mm-hmm.
Like, entertainment, it's, like she said, it's news every 30 seconds, right? And with entertainment, we want to talk about so much, but we only have, like, limited amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
So with the structure, it's like, okay, well, this is happening, this is better than this, but at the same time, this is what people listen. So we're going back and forth on different things that we need to talk about.
Yeah.
And so when we get on the show, it's just like, okay, so which one, we have to decide which one we're going to talk about now and which one we're going to talk about later. And I feel like structure was such a big thing that we needed to improve on, not just as hosts, as production overall, as a team.
Mm-hmm. Production meetings, that's what I think we all can do better on. You know, going back to what LaMondre said, as far as structure, I've been in the theater business since I was a little kid, so I know stage management, I know everything. I know how everything goes down. So, production, you know, production meetings are definitely something that'll definitely build success with us. Not saying we, you know, we were kind of trash at it. No, you know, we're all learning. So I think that would definitely help.
Anyone else wanted to answer that question? I want to hear everyone.
I think one of the biggest things was preparation. Like for my show, I know it can get repetitive. So just finding the right guest to fit, and then figuring out where we're gonna go from that week to the next week. That's one of the hardest part, because it's a lot of stuff that I could talk about, but just really figuring out what's gonna separate this show. Cause we got 5 different shows and everybody doing their own thing. So I don't wanna step on nobody else's toes. I don't wanna bring somebody that do sports and that they the sports network, you know, the sports zone, you know what I mean? So
I think preparation and really just managing the time of how much you put into the show, because it does take a lot of effort to really make this happen.
Mm-hmm. I feel like preparation, definitely. But one thing about the news show that's, and I didn't really notice the difference until I got on the sports show. The news show, it's so easy to be, I guess you could say, in a way, stiff. Like, I feel like a lot of y'all shows, it's easy for you guys to display your personality. But due to us reading from, the teleprompter, it's, you don't know, like, necessarily when to spice it up. But I feel like repetition is the father of learning. I feel like we started to get more comfortable, and then, TV studio not code no more, so we really get a little comfortable. Yes, so, I mean, just imagine, reading through the teleprompter, and then, trying not to shiver, and you reading, and so it's just that, and then just learning from, looking at the camera and talking instead of, talking with each other. You don't have to necessarily look in the camera. That's a big difference.
An additional thing with the Panther News Network that needs a little tweaking, I feel, is the prep time that we, the time that we take to get the show ready, get things started, get the script into the prompter. We need to be more quick on that and more time efficient so that we can start on time every single day and run our time how it's supposed to, when it's supposed to be. So, we can get in there and get out and go to our classes, and do all the other things that we have to do. But yeah, the stiffness thing, y'all, go watch episode 1, 2, 3. Y'all, we were so frozen, and we did that because when you look at news, you look and see, you're like, okay, this is serious, this is professional, we have to act like them, and so we just needed more personality in our show. But like Jeray said, it's kind of hard to depict when to allow that to come out when you're reporting actual, world regional PB news, that's about it for our show.
One thing I will say for our show is that sometimes I feel like we are a little tight. We always got something to talk about. We just got to loosen up a little bit more. And it was really cold one time. Cold one time, and we had a guest. And I
was shivering.
It gets really cold.
Yeah, I was licking my lips. I was licking my lips, and I was like, ooh, it's cold in here. I know my lips are chapped. But then I started looking at him, and he was doing the same thing, and his lips were shaking.
I'm trying not to laugh
at him. It can just be so difficult.
Okay, I know for a lot of you guys, this is kind of an eye-opener. And I don't think we really realize that there's people looking at us all the time. People are always watching.
Oh, this YouTube, baby.
It is, right? So I know me personally, I love to motivate others, Even though I'm in a little spot right now, but I'm higher than where I was last year.
For sure.
So what are some things, and this is open for everyone to answer, what are some things you tell yourself to keep yourself motivated, that keeps yourself pushing on?
Tell myself I'm not cold. You ain't cold.
One thing that I tell myself a lot, and I know it's kind of cliche, but don't let anybody else tell you what you can't do. I found myself, when I first got to college, I found myself listening to that. Oh, you can't do that because, or you can't do that because. Like, it's words, I used to feed into words a lot, but when I realized that the sky really is the limit, to whatever I can do, it's kept me going. So every time I feel like I'm, lagging, or I feel like I'm not worth anything, I just say, hey, don't stop, because you can, no matter what people say. So I always tell myself, don't stop.
For sure.
I like that.
Can I take this?
Sure.
Okay, cool. One thing, one thing I want to say, just continue to be innovative and continue to, strive for your passions, because whenever you have a job and your passion in your field, it's not a job. It's not, don't feel like work. It's just, you're just doing something that you love. And, whenever you do something that you love, and you show people, when you have a platform to show people that, it just shows the generation below us that, you can do whatever you want if you put your mind to it, and just sometimes take risks. You might feel that, you may fail, but failure is a good learning experience. So just continue to put yourself out there, take some risk, and be disciplined, and just go for your passions. Do it. Why not?
Does somebody have something? Go ahead.
Well, one thing, I beat myself up. Okay, cool. But one thing I always tell myself is expectations are the gateways to disappointments. So always expect the unexpected. Work smarter, not harder. And, you know, one thing that one of my professors told me was more of like a character. It's all about your character at the end of the day. Because, you know, I've came a long way when it comes to, you know, GPA, you know, coming from the bottom to high honors is, you know, hard work. And once I felt myself, you know, getting diminished and overwhelmed with a lot of work and, you know, trying to balance, you know, PVA, MUTV and all the other organizations, I just felt like I was just crashing. But, you know, really at the end of the day, it's all about character and it's all about, you know, just doing it.
I wanted to ask everybody, but you specifically, when this all first started, TDV told us that she didn't really just look for anybody, and she just looked for what we knew, like who she knew could do the best job for the shows. And you weren't there at first, but they put you on, and you've been doing the sports show since. How do you feel that you were able to be on the show? I feel like you were the only person that's, oh, we see him, put him on the show. How do you feel about that? Like, being able to just...
It was mind-blowing, like, how it all came about, because I really just got on the show, like, one of our co-hosts that's not here today, he just ended up missing one day. And she just threw me on the stage, and she was just like, oh, let's see what you can do. And then after she did it, like, she just came out the little room over there, and her face was just lit up. She was just like, yeah, he's supposed to be here. So it's like, when you get, because I always, like, had a passion for talking about sports. Like, anybody that know me, they know that's all I do all day is talk. So whenever she seen me just, like, on the stage, like, it was different. And I had never done that before, like, not in this setting, and, like, done it, like in front of a camera. Like, I thought I was going to be shaking. But it was, like, you could ask him, like, it was just natural for me. Like, I just talk. Like, you just catch points in the show where David's just looking at me, just listening to me. Like, whatever I'm talking about, David's just be interested because he don't be saying that. Like, how you doing now? He just listened to me. So, like, it just seemed like it was something I was supposed to do. And, like, that's something, like, y'all talking about, like, motivating factors. Whenever you feel like you don't know, like, where you're going in life, understand, like, you in that space for a purpose. Like, you there for a reason. Like, it's not, it didn't just happen just to happen. Like, it's there for you to be there. So that's my biggest
thing. Zach, I need to tell you something that's on my heart.
What's up?
Uh-oh. I seen you passing the mic and not wanting to talk. Don't ever do that ever again.
Uh-huh.
Because your passion is fighting to get out of you and to be shared to the world. Don't ever minimize yourself like that, because you talk.
Uh-huh.
And you just did that, like, boom. But you didn't want to talk at first. Don't ever do that ever again.
Yeah.
Because you got it.
She got on.
She did. I mean, I think it's one thing to say we all have a passion for something.
Yeah.
And I know, just hanging out with them all the time, we can see it through us. And now being with you guys more often, we can see it through you guys too. But we want to just say thank you guys so much for taking the time to come be on our show. We appreciate it so much.
Give y'all a
round of applause.
And give a round of applause for Professor Dalvet.
Yes.
We love you.
TV.
You over here.
Wow.
You hear us clapping.
So, you know, I loved it.
I loved it too.
I love this.
It ain't over.
It's not over.
Well, it's not over. So
we can talk about the round table talk if we wanted to, but you know, we cool people too.
Yeah.
So we'll be back after this commercial break.
Traditions are not made overnight. They are created through a legacy of excellence and a commitment to something much greater. For more than 135 years, Prairie View A&M University has provided students with a strong academic foundation, a unique college experience, and the opportunity to make their mark on the world. This is a place where friendships are formed, discoveries are made, and dreams are realized. This is Prairie View A&M University, our tradition, your opportunity.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound, and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome back to the Roundtable Talk, you guys. I'm Lamaya Perlina, and we are closing our segment with you all. First, I just want to say thank you to my wonderful co-host for sticking in here.
Ice me out.
Yes, we will be back next semester with another season of the Roundtable Talk. Thank you for sticking in with us, hearing us talk and ramble about these crazy things.
Yeah, because we talk a lot.
Yeah.
About you nonsense. Have a favorite episode?
My favorite episode was the one with Muhammad after the march at PV for voting. Yeah. That was my favorite one because I felt like he really dropped some gems. And we interacted, and the one we did with the stress because we interacted Twitter. Yeah. We interacted with Twitter to see.
I did like that one too.
Same episode.
Mm-mm, wasn't the same episode.
I'm trying to be smart and stuff.
What was your favorite episode?
I've been so cold in all of them.
What was your favorite one?
Which one were you?
It might have to be the one with Kendall.
Our first one?
Yeah, our first one. The pilot is what they call it.
Oh. Excuse me. The pilot.
The pilot.
That was your favorite one?
Yeah, because those were people I actually... No. Like, yeah, Kendall got on me one day because I had ate some pizza in his closet, and I accidentally left a pizza crust in his closet.
Anthony, why were you eating pizza in the closet?
How'd you end up eating pizza?
Because it's PVTV right here. So that's nothing we need to talk about right now. But I was hungry, and I was in the closet.
Were you hiding from somebody?
No, I was watching something.
You were hiding from somebody.
That sounds kind of creepy.
We was just watching me and my, I don't know who it was on the other side. Because, you know, in the UC, they got the, it's two closets.
Anthony. No, that's not okay. That's okay.
We've been cool ever since. He wouldn't even bring it up again.
Tony, what was your favorite episode?
You know, I think my favorite episode had to be when we were talking about domestic violence, when Marshayla came and talked about, like, her experience and her documentary. Mm-hmm. I thought that was just so cool. Oh, and when you opened up, because you literally had me on stage almost in tears, came out of nowhere. But I love when our guests come and they're able to, like, really show us who they are.
Yeah,
I really love that. Yeah, they actually take a moment and like you said, they be vulnerable with us. I love it so much.
I love it. Mm-hmm. Is there anything coming up on campus? Finals.
Finals.
I think that's it, y'all. Just the finals week.
Graduation gonna be here soon. What, December? I ain't graduating. Is it December 13th? 16th. See, if I was graduating, I'd know.
Man, that's kind of late.
I ain't gonna be here.
Oh, AKA, we have an event actually on December 3rd, Little Dresses with Africa.
Yeah.
So definitely, I know, I love it. We make little cute little dresses and it's so cute. But yes, y'all come out to that. I forgot where it's gonna be, but you know, if you follow me on Instagram,
you'll see it.
Go ahead.
I just want y'all to be on my Instagram too, because I interview Blame It On Quay. Y'all may know him as TT. I'm about to drop that interview this weekend. That's all I gotta say.
Stay tuned. We're doing big things. Stay tuned. PVTV.
What if I got something I need to talk about?
I wasn't done. I was just saying we was going up.
You looking at the camera?
Because I have to look. Well, okay, I say I was going up. Okay.
I don't got nothing I want to talk about, but y'all could at least let me say something.
Close it out.
All right. Congratulations to all the 2018 graduates. We're going to be back with it even harder next semester. They're going to be back at it even harder next semester. And We gonna do big things. We about to blow up.
I'm Amaya Perlina.
I'm Anthony Peterson.
And it's your girl, Tony Hall, AKA Glasses and Puff.
Ooh. This is the round table.
I just came up with that right.
Look at you.